Yes, good afternoon to all. So we are discussing about organic qualitative analysis. In that one, last time we have taken binary mixture, soil plus solid. For that, first we have to see that nature is soil solid. So just by physical appearance, so this is a compound, just by the physical appearance you can say that it is a soil plus solid. If it is soil plus liquid, so we have seen that we have to take the drops on this such type of glass plate, and after putting this droplets of the soil liquid on this glass plate, after some time it get evaporate, and on this glass plate we have such type of soil particle. So you may say that it is a soil plus liquid, right? It is a soil plus liquid, right? Now, if suppose the given compound, if it is liquid, then what happen? So here, what I will do, I will take some droplets of this compound on the glass plate, and we have to check whether you are having a soil particle or not. If you are having soil particle either of previous one, then you can say that it is soil liquid, otherwise it is a liquid. So here I have taken this liquid on this glass plate, right? You can see right, these are the glass plate, right? So this is your liquid part, and just you have to wait for some time. Otherwise, what you can do, you can take this wire gauge, and you can take this wire gauge. You have to heat this wire gauge on the burner, and you have to heat this wire gauge on the burner, and you have to put this glass plate which have the liquid, right? Which have the liquid, right? So that you are going to provide the energy, and you are going to provide the energy, and on this one, if you are having the soil particle, then you can say that it is a soil liquid. If you don't have the soil particle, if you have the only liquid, then you can say that it is a liquid. So look, in the previous case, you are having such type of soil particle, but in this case, you are not having solid, even though we have put on the wire gauge. In the previous one, just you put the drops, you get such type of the soil particle. So you can say, as it is a liquid, so you can say it is a liquid. So the first case is the nature that you have seen, it is a liquid plus liquid. When the nature is soil plus liquid, liquid plus liquid, so the second step is not type, you have to go for the separation. So you have to take the solution. In this one, you have to add a small porcelain piece, right? So here we have added the small porcelain piece for the constant heating, so that extra heat get absorbed by your compound. And you can make an assembly. So just you can hold this one like this one, right? And you can fit by using you can put the Hickman here. You can Hickman here, you can put here Hickman here, and then you can make an assembly, and you have to make an assembly like this one. So you have to make an assembly like this one. Right? So what you are having? You are having water bath, which has a liquid. Then in that one you have RB. In that RB you are having the mixture, binary mixture. Here you are having the Hickman head, and here with your water condenser, you have to put this water condenser like this one. Okay. Now this is your complete assembly. Now you have to heat the solution. So again, you have to heat only by the one burner, but as to save the time, I am using the another burner only to heat the water inside this water bath, so that the solution get heated, and then the first liquid having the lower boiling point, it will come out. Here having two liquid, first liquid and second liquid. The first liquid having the lower boiling point will come out first, and the second which having the higher boiling point will remain inside the RB, and then you can take it's a time. So again it takes some time, as we have seen in the previous case also. Otherwise you have to wait for some time for the constant heating and slow heating. So we are very thankful to our lab assistant Mr. Suhas Mohite for helping, for making all this arrangement and making all the proper arrangement for the chemicals, the gasifiers. So due to that one, we are able to give this type of demonstration very easily. We have seen that when we heat the water in the water bath, it gets heated, it start heating. Then the solution in the RB, it also heated. So it has the two compound. First liquid having the lower boiling point, it start boiling. It start boiling, and at this boiling point, it will come out. So at a particular temperature, all the liquid will come out and get collected in the Hickman head. At a particular temperature, maximum liquids will come out. So you have to understand that it is the boiling point of that first liquid. And when liquid do not come out, then we have to understand that most of the liquid it get evaporated and it get collected in the Hickman head. So here I told you already that if you heat, if water in the water bath, it gets boiled, and even though the first liquid, if it do not come out, then you have to understand that it is having the higher boiling point. So you can remove the water bath, and you can heat slowly, slowly the liquid by putting the wire gauge on the tripod scan. Again, you have to take care while doing performing the experiment. So here you must be always away from this platform. Always you have to wear safety goggles and apron, so that the chemicals will not fall on your body. If you wear boot, then chemicals will not fall on your boot. Yeah. When you are using the binary mixture, or when you are using the semi micro analysis, the chemicals will be very, very pure, so that at that temperature you get the proper result. The solution is going to boil, it takes time for boiling. Or putting the assembly at a particular platform, you have to check the quality of the burner, everything, so that you should get proper heating. Temp should be good. Now it is going to start boiling out. Now it may come out. The solution in the RB is going to boil and the vapors will get evaporated and get collected in the treatment head. So you have to take the you should have some patience while learning science. So you add the chemicals and you get results, it's not so. So you have to wait and you have to observe what is going to happen. So in the as compared to this one, the first liquid come out fast. But here it takes some time, means it indicates that the boiling point of the first liquid is higher than the previous one. If you have any doubt, you may ask. If someone is having doubt, then ask any question. Now look here, the drops are coming out and it's going to collect in the heat here. So, how do things relate to yourself? You must have the observation and then you can learn. So, only by observing, if someone is doing and only you are observing, you cannot learn. Compound is coming out. I'm going to collect in the treatment head. The liquid has collected, just I will stop the burner and I have to collect this one. So both burner I will close it, then let it cool. After cooling you can take this water condenser, and you can attach at somewhat high place, so that very easily you can remove this liquid one here. Okay. Now we have test tube, right? This is Hickman head where the first liquid gets collected, right? So here we have to add into the test tube this is first liquid, and the second liquid is inside the RP. So you have to go for the type. So same thing, whether it is the water soluble, then you have to go for the litmus test. If it is water insoluble, then you have to go for the chemical test. So this compound is the water soluble or not? Just I will take it. So I will take test tube, right? And I will take water. Whether we are having one layer or not, you have to check it, right? Then I will add water. When you add water, you will see that you are not having two layer. It is having only one layer, right? Then we have to check the litmus test. So here is a real litmus paper, right? And here is a blue litmus paper, right? Blue litmus paper. When you put a drop of that one, when you put a drop of that one, I'll put on the drop. On the blue also and red also. So here you see that there is no change in the color in the blue. It indicates that it is not acid. And even though when I put a drop on this red litmus paper, also there is no change in the color. Means it is not acid, not a base. Means the compound is neutral in nature. Okay. Similarly, you can take the another compound into the test tube and you can check whether it is a water soluble or not. So here it is your first liquid and your second liquid, right? And I will add water. So here you will see that you are getting two layers, right? You are getting the two layers, first layer and the second layer. That means it is the water immiscible. Means you have to check whether it is the acid base or phenol by using the chemical test, right? So I will take test tube, right? And you have to add sodium bicarbonate. You have to check whether you are having influence or not, right? So here you are having only two layers, means it is immiscible. It is immiscible, right? Otherwise, you should get only one layer. So it is immiscible. So you may say that acid is absent, right? Acid is absent. Otherwise, you should get the one layer. Similarly, you can go for the base, you know, and base. Here, I will take the liquid, then I will add HCl or NaOH. So you must get one layer, but here again you are having two layers, means it is a immiscible. Okay, it is not soluble. Then we take HCl. Here is HCl. So again, you see that there are two layers. This is the immiscible. Now here I will take the litmus test. Here is the blue litmus paper and here is the red litmus paper. And here is your liquid. Just you have to put one drop on both of them, and you will see that there is a no change in the color, means it is a neutral mixture. It is a neutral mixture. So here the second mixture, liquid liquid, both are neutral in nature. So we have said that the in liquid liquid one can give the neutral neutral. Why? Because in this case, first you have to go for the separation by the critical constant, and then you have to go for the type determination. So in this case, you have seen the type of the three compounds: 5 plus solid, 5 plus liquid, and a liquid plus liquid. So in this one, if you have any doubt, you may ask. So here we stop. Thanks to all.